Hey folks, what's up? Jeremy Schaefer here. Today I'm going to show you how to fold a new model I designed. This is a magic hat, and guess what's going to pop out of it? 3, 2, 1, bloop! There's the bunny rabbit. This design was roughly based on Robert Neal's Rabbit in the Hat, otherwise known as Bunny Bill. But this model was really inspired by my friend Heather Rogers, who is a magician, and she suggested that I try to improve upon Robert Neal's Bunny Bill. And so this was my attempt at making the rabbit a little bit cuter and getting the eyes in there. So, all right. So you want to learn how to fold it? Ready, set, here it goes. All right, so first step, let's turn the bill over. Now you could use an ordinary 3x7 rectangle of paper, but then you won't have these two eyes on the bunny. These two spirally dots were specifically placed on the dollar for us origamists, so we need to make use of them. But if you don't have a dollar, then you'll just have to color the eyes on there or not. Okay, let's fold in half. And unfold, and let's rotate so that the eagle is nearest to you. And let's turn over right to left. And let's fold this edge to the middle crease, just like a paper airplane fold, but just on one side. Okay, now let's take this point and fold it to this point. And let's unfold this flap, and let's extend this fold all the way across. And let's rotate, and now let's fold this edge up to the top. And let's turn over top to bottom. And now let's fold this edge to the left edge, but we're just going to make a little pinch mark right on the right edge, right here. Okay, unfold. And now let's fold this edge to the crease mark. And now let's fold this top flap behind, and we're going to line it up with this edge. So just mount and fold it and line it up. Okay, let's turn over. And now we're going to fold this flap up. How far? Well, we're going to try to make it be the same as the back flap here. So line it up so that this edge and this edge touch. Okay, and just make a crease mark there, and let's do the same thing here. Make a crease mark, and now fold all the way across. Now let's rotate, and now we're going to fold this edge up to the crease. And when you do it, it's best to hold right here so that the paper doesn't slip. That'll just make it a little bit cleaner. And let's rotate, and now let's fold this edge to here. And once again, hold right here so the paper doesn't slip. Okay. And now let's do a squash fold. So what we're going to do is stick your finger right in this pocket, and we're going to squash this up. And you want it to squash so that this edge lines up with this edge. So just like that. And let's do the same on the left side. So open this pocket and squash it just like this. Okay, now let's fold this edge to this edge. Once again, hold right here so the paper doesn't slip. And the same on this side, so rotate and fold this edge up to here. folding right here. Okay, now we're going to unfold this flap and we're going to squash right here. And when you squash, just make sure that this crease lines up with this edge so that it's a isosceles right triangle. Okay, and let's do the same thing here. So let's unfold this flap and squash right here. Okay, let's rotate. And now we're going to fold this edge up to this point, and we're going to make a valley fold between this point and this point. So just grab this edge and we're going to fold it up, and the paper is going to come out from underneath this edge. So just fold it up just like this and bring this edge up to right here and flatten. Okay, so again, it was like this, and we just folded it up like that. Okay, let's do the same thing on this side. So we're folding between these two points, and we're folding this edge up and flatten. Okay, now let's reach in here and pull out the raw corner all the way to the right. And let's do the same thing on this side. So reach in and pull out the raw corner all the way to the left. Okay, let's rotate. And now let's fold this edge right up to this edge. And rotate. And now let's fold this edge to this edge. And now let's unfold this flap and let's rotate. And now we're going to fold this flap up and we're going to fold this edge onto itself, and we're folding right on this point. So just fold the flap up like this. Okay, now let's let this rear flap swing out and let's unfold this flap. And now we're going to pull this raw corner out from underneath here and just pull it all the way out to the right. And now you want to squash it so that this edge is parallel with this edge. Like this. Okay, let's repeat on the left side. So pull out the raw corner, slide it out, and flatten. And crease very sharply here. And now let's fold this flap down. And we're going to fold this edge right up to our crease line. And let's rotate. And now let's fold this edge up to this edge. And let's unfold this flap just like this. Okay, let's repeat on this side. So let's fold this flap down and let's fold this edge to this crease. Okay, and let's rotate. And now let's fold this edge to this edge. And let's unfold this flap. Okay, and now let's fold this edge to this edge. Okay. And the same thing on the left side. Fold this edge to this edge. Okay, crease sharply. Okay, now let's mount and fold in half like this. And let's turn over. And now we're going to pull this whole flap, bend it downward. So just hold here and hold here and rotate out like this. Okay. Looks good. And flatten. Okay, now let's open here and squash down like this. And turn over. And now we're going to fold this flap up right on this crease here. And you can let the rear flap swing out like this. Okay, now let's fold this flap up right on this point. And turn over. And now we're going to fold this flap up, and we're going to fold it up right on this point. And how far? Well, what we want is for this segment to be about the same length as this segment. So I guess it's best to make it as a mountain fold. So just fold it like this. And let's do the same thing on the left side. So let's mountain fold right on this point. And make this edge the same length as this edge. Okay, and crease well. And now let's turn over. And now we're going to fold this edge right up to these two points. Now this is a very thick flap, so just do your best. Just use your fingernails. And crease it really well. That and unfold, and we're going to use that later. Okay, now let's fold this edge up to the horizontal edge. And ooh, hi bunny. Okay, and unfold, and now let's fold this edge up to this edge. Now we're going to rabbit ear. Well, actually, rabbit head. Okay, so let's squeeze the head in half like this and make our two folds just like that. And now we're going to mountain fold the hat in half and rotate. And now what we're going to do is basically fold the hat back like this, but let's do it one flap at a time. So let's fold this flap in front. Now what we're going to do is fold it in front like this. We're going to place this edge underneath this edge and just bring it as far forward as it can go, like that. And now let's turn over and do it on this side. So let's fold this flap over and we're sticking this edge underneath this edge. And we're basically just folding the hat in half. And there is our bunny. Okay, and Now let's try to work on the bunny's head. So what we're going to do is remake that fold. So fold these edges in right on the crease that we just made, and now just press it down. And you want to just squeeze the nose right here. So just put your fingernail right underneath the nose, and just like that. And now try to make it come to a point if you can. And now just put your fingernail under the nose and push it down. Just like that. And try to make it even. And there's the bunny's face. Okay. And you can do anything you want to the ears, maybe curl them a little bit. All right, now let's unfold the hat. And we're going to close the bunny up like a pop-up card. So let's bend the head back. And as we close the hat in this direction, the bunny can go inside like this. Okay, so there is the pop-up card, and this actually works. You see, it pops up like that, and that's kind of neat. But there's a way that we can make it even pop more forward, and so this is what we're going to do. This is optional. First, let's fold this flap up right on this edge right here, so like that, and the same thing on this side. Let's fold this right on this edge, okay? And now let's open this flap right here, and now reach right in here and push right on this edge. Just push it in, so it's like that. And now when you close the hat back up, the rabbit comes up like that. And now when you open it, see, the rabbit really comes forward like that. And I think that that's just a lot nicer and more effective. But it does mean that the rabbit is sort of poking up a little bit. It might be harder to conceal the rabbit. But this is how you can conceal it. What you do is you hold the two ears between these two fingers like this, and then grab on here. So it really pulls the rabbit down. So you have a pretty big angle with which to work with. And then when you want to make the rabbit appear, then you just pull like that. You just basically push right here. You're holding onto the ears, and you just push right on the middle of the hat, and poof, there's the bunny. That's the action. And if you look from this side, you see this also looks like a bunny. My friend Tara saw this side and recognize this as a bunny. And she said, it's a bunny wearing a kimono. So I thought that was pretty neat. And so yeah, there's the bunny. The bunny is going to perform a magic trick. We need a hat. So let's find a hat. Okay, so here is our hat. And abracadabra, and whoop, there's the bunny. And the bunny's sniffing around. All right, well, I hope you guys enjoyed folding this, and let me know what you think. Well, that's all, folks. Bye-bye.